हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू नागेश कलजगी ऑर्किड स्कूल. आई एम पूजा राजमाने. आई एम योर कंप्यूटर टीचर. वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट आवर लेसन नंबर 5. व्हाट इज द नेम ऑफ दिस लेसन? मोर अबाउट माइक्रोसॉफ्ट विंडोज. व्हाट इज मीन बाय विंडोज? यस, विंडोज इज वन ऑफ द ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम, राइट? एंड फर्स्ट स्क्रीन ऑफ विंडो, व्हेन वी स्टार्ट द कंप्यूटर, वी कैन सी द फर्स्ट स्क्रीन. दैट स्क्रीन इज कॉल्ड एज अ डेस्कटॉप. That we discussed in last period only. Now we will start our new lesson. Name of the lesson is WordPad and it is 6th number lesson. We will see here. What is the name of lesson? WordPad. What is mean by WordPad? That also we discussed in last period only. Where is the WordPad? How to open the WordPad? That also we will see. Okay, what is mean by WordPad? We will see this first. WordPad is a basic word processor. Firstly, tell me, WordPad is the hardware or software? Good. WordPad is the software. WordPad is the basic word processor which is more advanced than the Notepad. Means WordPad is more advanced than Notepad. We discussed about Notepad also, right? But WordPad is more advanced than Notepad, but simpler than Microsoft Word. Means these three, means WordPad, Notepad and Microsoft Word, these three are useful for writing the text, editing the text, but Notepad is the first step. Then WordPad and then Microsoft Word. So that means we can say like that it is more advanced than the Notepad but simpler than the Microsoft Word. A word processor is a computer program. Word processor is a computer program that you can use to, what is the use of this WordPad? Create, edit, format, view and print text document. Means by using WordPad we can write, we can edit the text, we can format and we can view and we can take print out also. WordPad is used to type letter and simple documents. What is the use of WordPad? If you want to write or if you are type, that time we can use WordPad. The basic feature, why we are using the WordPad, what is the feature of the WordPad? Is to create a document, edit and format the type the text, move sentence and paragraphs and copy and paste text within and between the document. Means what is the use of WordPad? Why we are using the WordPad? For writing the document, for typing the document, edit means already if it is written, then we can edit it. We can format in that. And again, we can move the sentence or paragraph also. Means first number paragraph, we can move as a last number paragraph also. And we can copy and paste also this paragraph or sentence of word within and between the document. Now, how to open the WordPad? Step to open the WordPad. How to open the WordPad? Firstly, click on the start button. Where is the start button? Start button is on the taskbar. Where is the taskbar? Yes, this downside line on the screen or on the desktop is called as a taskbar. And this line, this symbol, you can see it is called as a start button. Then click on the start button, then all program, then accessories and then WordPad. How to open the WordPad? Click on the start button, all program, accessories and then we will get the WordPad. Everyone got it? How to open the WordPad? Start, start button, all program, accessories and word pad. We will see one more time. Start button, all program, accessories and then word pad. We will see this type of window. It is called as a word pad. Now we will see component of the word pad. That also we have already discussed in last period, in last lesson. Then also we will see one more time. Now what is it? You only tell me the name of this component. First one is a, what is it? First number is, it is title bar. What it is? It is title bar. See, this is the blue color line is only title bar, not this downside. It is only title bar. This one, you can see, this blue and this blue is different. This box is called as a word pad button. Word pad button. Now next one is quick access toolbar. Where is the quick access toolbar? This line and one small triangle is called as a quick access toolbar. Quick access toolbar, and this you can see here, it is called as a ribbon. What it is? It is ribbon. And the small, the small blinking line is called as a cursor. But there are only four main components. Which are they? Title bar, word pad button, ribbon and quick access bar or quick access toolbar. Now we will see in detail about the title bar. Now everyone repeat with me. There are four main components of the word pad button. First one is a title bar. Next one is a word pad button and the ribbon. And last one is quick access bar, quick access toolbar. Okay, now what is the use of title bar? Anyone can tell me? We already discussed in last period. What is the use of title bar? Do you see here? What is the use of title bar? See, title bar. It displays the title of document or file on which the user is working out. Means, what is the name of given document or file is displayed on title bar. See, it is title bar. We will see here. It is title bar. And title bar, this side is quick access toolbar, and these are the three buttons. What do you call that three buttons? Good. These are control buttons, right? These are control buttons. And what is the use of these three buttons? These three buttons, one button having different use. Control buttons. What is it? It is minimize. Good. Minimize button, maximize button, and last one is close button. These three buttons are called as a control button. In that, first one is minimize button, next one is maximize button, and last one is close button. What is the use of minimize button? Yes, good. If you want to minimize the size of window, mini means what? Small. If you want to small our window, if you want to do minimize our window, that time we can use this button. We will see here. When I press here, then this window will be appear in taskbar, right? Now next one is maximize button. What is the use of maximize button? When we press on this maximize button, then this window will be appear as a full screen. And what is the use of close button? When our work is finished on this window, if you want to close this window, that time we can close this word pack. Close. What is use about the minimize, maximize and close? Now we will see about the WordPad button. Where is the WordPad button? Downside the title bar. Title bar displays the name of file or document. Now we will see about the WordPad button. What is the use of WordPad button? When we press this button, by using that button, if you want to take a new WordPad, then we can take new. If you want to open already exit file that we have saved, if you want to open this file, then by using open option we can open it. Next one is save. For what is the use of save option? Yes, by using save option we can store our file in computer. Next one is save. Next one is print. Suppose we write in a computer, and if you want this on paper, by using print option we can take it on paper. Next one is page setup. For printing we can set our page and exit means first. Same, it is work like a close button. When I press the exit, then it will be, this window will be exit. Now we will see here. First one is what? It is title bar and WordPad button. To open a new file or to create a new file, how to create a new file? Click the WordPad menu button and then click the new. A new blank document open which look like a blank sheet of paper. Here you can type text and content. We'll see here. It is WordPad. And what it is? WordPad button. When I click here and if I press here on new, then new document will be come. I will write here, then you understand it is new. ABCE. When I press here new, then this will become a new. Then new WordPad file will be open. New blank sheet will be open. Next one is a cursor. What is meant by cursor? You can see here this line. The blinking vertical line is a cursor where the text that you type will appear. What is the use of this cursor? It's showing which number or where we are typing now. It is showing. We will type here, then you understand. air pollution. Okay, where is my cursor now? Here it is showing the position of this cursor. Is showing position means where we are exactly now. It is showing the cursor. Now before writing, our cursor is here. Now our cursor is here. It is small blinking line. Now we will write little bit. How to write? Which key now I am using for writing? Good. Alphabet key on the keyboard. Firstly, we will increase the size of this text. How to increase the size of the text? For each and every effect, we must have to select it. How to select? This also you having. We will see this afterwards. Firstly, I will show you. Now you understand. Air pollution. Now, suppose we want to save this. Then how to save this? How to save this file? Click on the WordPad button. Where? Click on the WordPad button and then click on the save button. Then this type of window will be appear. How to do? First step is click on the WordPad button and then click on the save. Means now they are asking where to save. We will save this on desktop. Then we must have to select the path where we want to save. If we save as it is, then it will be stored in documents. But we want this file on the desktop. Then desktop also having different folders, right? We will save as it is, not in folder. Suppose already we have created one folder, that time we can select folder from here also. But now we will save directly on the desktop. Here they are asking for file name. We will write here name, file name. We can write any name. We can write as a number to name also. Means here now what I write here, air pollution. Then I can write here which number chapter here, 6 number chapter. Then I will give that file name as a 6 also, no problem. Then click on the save. Then it display air pollution in title bar. Good, that's why it is called as a title bar. Title bar display the name of file or program. Got it? How to save? Click on the WordPad button and then save. Then one window will be appear and then give the file name and click on the save. Now we will cut from here. Suppose we want to see his what we given now name air pollution. Suppose now we want to open this file. This file is already exist in our computer. It is in our computer and now we want to see this file. How to see this file? Firstly, open the WordPad. Then click on the WordPad button. Where to click? Click on the WordPad button. Now what we want to? We want to open already exist file. This file is already exist. This file is we created already. Now we want to open it. Then click on the open. Then where is our file in document? No, this file is on desktop. Then desktop and then what is the file name? Good, air pollution. Then search it. air pollution and then open. We write this only. Right or wrong? Understand how to open already exit file? Got it? How to open already exit file? How to save file? How to write in WordPad? Now we will see about the page setup option. Page setup option. What is the use of page setup option? This option is used before printing a document for any changes that need to be made in the size of paper. There are three main options, which are the size, orientation and margin. Means suppose we write this in computer, right? And suppose this page we want in a paper, but we want this in middle. We can change the position of this paper. How to change this position of the paper or page? Page setup option. Okay, first one is size, means we can select the, here is the size of paper. Mostly we are using, means which type of paper we are using. We are using A4 size or A3 size. Here we are using A4 size. Now it will be look like that. Now next one is orientation. What changes will happen? This, see here. Don't look here and there. See here. Suppose I choose this, then you can see changes here. What I select here? I select here A4. Then see here. Orientations are two types. Which are they? Portrait and landscape. This already it is which? It is portrait. Right? Landscape, you only tell what is the use of landscape. See here. When I select this orientation, then what will happen? What happen? This will be appear like that. Okay? Portrait mean like that and landscape. Portrait of landscape. Where is it? It is in a orientation. Paper size. Size means which size we are using for printing. Size of the paper we are using for printing. Now next one is margin. Next one is margin. From left side. Left side, if we write here number, then it will leave the space. You can see the changes. Means that number of space they are taking. See here, 3. If I reduce here, 2, then also you see the changes. And if I increase, then also you see the change. Okay, we will take only 2. Now from right side also we will give 2 number. If we write 3 number, then see the changes. If you write here only 2. Now from top means what? Upper side. From upper side, see here everyone. If you want to leave the space from top side, then also we can leave. See, got it? What is the use of page setup? Here also we will take 2 only. And from bottom side means at the end of the side, here also we can leave the space. See, we will take here also 2. What is the use of page setup option? Means there are 3 main options, which are the size of the paper, then next is a orientation, and next is a margin in inch. In page size in size option we can select the size of this paper. Next, orientation means landscape or portrait. Next one is a margin. We can leave the space from left, right, top, bottom, and afterwards click on the OK. Now next option is to select page setting before printing. Click on the WordPad menu button, picture, then click the page setup and select the option you want. A window of page setup will be appear. Right? When we click there, then this type of window will be appear, and then we can change the size of paper, then orientation, see here, then we can change the size, orientation and margin as desired or desired for printing the document. Now we will read this. The page setup dialog box allows you to customize some of the features of the document you want to print. For example, you can change the size of your paper as well as the margin at the top, bottom and either the edges of the paper. The page setup dialog box look like this picture. Okay, got it everyone? Now only we see this practical as a demo. Got it? Now next one is, what is the component? Which are the main four component of the WordPad window? Title bar, then WordPad button, and then ribbon and quick access toolbar. Right? Now what we learn in this period? Title bar. What is the use of title bar? It displays the name of document or file. And title bar having the three main buttons. That buttons are called as a control buttons. And what is the use of these buttons? That also we learned. We discuss about that buttons also. Now next component is WordPad button. By using this WordPad button, we can create a new file, we can open a already exit file, we can save the file, or we can take printout, or before taking a printout, we can set this page. Now remaining part means the two components. Which are the remaining two components? Ribbon and the quick access toolbar. We will see these in next period. Now what is the homework for you? You know very well. You must have to underline the hard words. Thank you.